Welcome to the Commentaries, a podcast series from TAN in which you'll learn how to read and understand history's greatest Catholic works from today's greatest Catholic scholars. In every series of the Commentaries, your expert host will be your personal guide to not just read the book, but to live the book, shining the light of its eternal truths into our modern darkness. Visit tancommentaries.com to get your copy of the book and to subscribe for access to all the great reading plans, new episodes, bonus content, and exclusive deals for listeners of the Commentaries.
Hello, and welcome back. I'm Father Edward Looney. I'm a priest of the Diocese of Green Bay, a pastor, an author, a podcaster, Marian theologian, and at present, the president of the Mariological Society of America. And this is the Commentaries series on the Glories of Mary by St. Alphonsus Liguori. Today is day number 8, and we will be treating part 1, referring to the Salve Regina, and specifically chapter 7, Turn then thine eyes of mercy toward us. But before we dive into this text, let's first begin with a prayer. Let us simply pray a Hail Mary. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Every time you pray the Hail Mary, you say those words. Pray for me, Mary, at the hour of my death. Have you been at the bedside of someone who has died or someone in the process of dying? They're at their last hours. Are you keeping vigil with them? Have you kept vigil? What do you do in that time? Maybe you pray the rosary? Maybe the Divine Mercy Chaplet? Sometimes the death of an individual, there can be a great holiness surrounding it. Maybe they say Jesus, his name, at the very end. Maybe they say, there's Mary. You begin to wonder, well, was Mary in the room? She could have been. We don't know the great phenomena that could take place. Every time we pray that Hail Mary, we're asking her to be there at the hour of our death, that God would make her aware of our hour, that she would know of it from her place in eternity. Mary was surrounded by death in her life. The first death, you know, that she really encounters is the death of the Holy Innocents. That because Jesus was born of her, these other children, they die as a result because a ruler is envious. We know that Joseph dies before the public ministry of Jesus. So Mary has her presence there, holding the hand of her husband, the one who protected her all throughout life, who helped raise the child Jesus. She knows the death of the cross, Jesus dying on the crucifix. She was there at that hour. She held his body, obviously an image that captivated the mind of Michelangelo with the Pietà, Mary holding the lifeless body of Jesus. Mary knows death. She knows of Christians who died after the ascension of Jesus. Surely She, like Jesus, experienced great sorrow over the death of John the Baptist. So Mary knows what it's like to be with someone as they die. She knows what it's like to mourn. St. Alphonsus Liguori in our reading and all throughout the Glories of Mary gives us little snippets of Mary's help at the hour of death for certain clients of hers, devotees. Mary, it says, sends angels at the hour of death. St. Michael comes and does battle for us. So we have Our Lady in that last hour of our life, that as we request it, God is going to honor that request, that Mary is going to pray for us at the hour of our death. There's a joke that Fulton Sheen would say. Fulton Sheen would say that St. Peter was wondering how all these souls got into heaven. And then he was told, well, your mother let them in through the back door. But isn't that what happens sometimes? That the soul at the hour of their death, Our Lady intercedes and obtains the grace of salvation and conversion in that final hour? That God has victory over evil and Satan and the tempter in that hour? I think we need to be better aware of how Mary is praying for us. She's praying for us now, in this very moment. And she will pray for us at the hour of our death. We repeat that prayer of the Hail Mary so many times. Think about how many rosaries you've prayed in your life. Every rosary. 50 Hail Marys in the decades. 53 if you count the first three. If we think about the rosary, there are these promises that were given to Blessed Alan de la Roche. And some of these promises revolve around the hour of our death. Promise number 7, for example. Whoever shall have a true devotion for the rosary shall not die without the sacraments of the church. I hope that's true. So that I might die fortified by the sacrament of the anointing of the sick, that I might be commended to Almighty God with the last rites and last prayers of the church. It's a promise for those, the hour of their death, who've prayed the rosary. Those who are faithful to recite the rosary shall have during their life and at their death the light of God and the plenitude of his graces. At the moment of death, they shall participate in all the merits of the saints in paradise. I shall deliver from purgatory those who have been devoted to the rosary. I have obtained from my divine Son that all advocates of the rosary shall have for intercessors the entire celestial court during their life and at the hour of death. These are promises that Mary gave to Blessed Alan de la Roche. Some would tell you, be dismissive of these promises because they're private revelation. The church doesn't necessarily uphold them. Blessed Alan maybe was wrong and how he communicated them after the fact. Now, don't be devoted to the rosary for the sake of the promises. Be devoted to the rosary out of love for God and out of love for Our Lady and wanting to ask her intercession, wanting to keep her company and have her help you in your meditation. That's why you pray the rosary. But know and take comfort in the fact that if you pray the rosary, these promises are going to be yours. That you will have Mary's help and all of the angels and saints helping and interceding for you at the hour of your death. Sometimes when we pray the Hail Mary, don't we say it hurriedly, rushed? Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. We say it quickly. We want to get the rosary done and over with. But maybe we would do better to relish those words. We would do better to really think of, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death, and what that means. Take comfort. Rest assured that if you're devoted to Our Lady, she's going to be interceding for you at the hour of your death. What you have asked, you shall receive. This brings us to the close of our reflection today on day number 8, as we reflected on Mary and the hour of our death. I hope that you'll join me tomorrow as we continue thinking about death and the afterlife. Tomorrow we will be addressing chapter 8. And after this, our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. I hope you'll join me again tomorrow. Until then, may God bless you, and Mary pray for you. And may she pray for you now and at the hour of your death. Amen.
This has been an episode of The Commentaries, a podcast brought to you by Tan. To follow the show, study more of the greatest Catholic classics, and to support the commentaries and other great free content from Tan, visit tancommentaries.com to subscribe and use coupon code COM25 to get 25% off your next order, including the Glories of Mary and countless more spiritual works to deepen your interior life and guide you to heaven.